It's Parliament's last sitting week before Christmas, and Albo's getting exactly what he wished for.
The decision by the crossbenchers to back Labor's bill is the right one.
The government received the Yuletide gift of crossbench support and will, this Saturday, legislate industrial wages law that it hopes will
get wages moving.
These laws, which allow unions to negotiate deals across multiple employers, will now be supported by the Greens and Balance of Power Senator David Pocock after the government agreed to key changes, including an increase to the small business threshold.
When it comes to small businesses, I pushed really hard for safeguards. The small business cap is now at 20.
So basically, if Santa employs fewer than 20 elves in his workshop, he can be excluded from this law. But even if he expands to a workforce of 50, he may still be able to opt out, with the onus now on the elf union to prove why he shouldn't be allowed to.
Getting rid of some of the red tape that we've got there will actually bring some of those businesses back to the table straight away.
But business groups are urging the government to wait, claiming the bill will not increase wages, instead leading to more confusion and chaos.
That creates a lot of uncertainty, it creates a lot of anxiety for employers, and there's no guarantee of wage increases going up anytime soon.
Now, small businesses having to fork out $14,000 as part of the process, that was never told to anybody before the election.
And there was another employment overhaul stocking stuffer today, with the government passing its Respect at Work law.
The new laws will place a positive duty on employers to take reasonable and proportionate measures to eliminate sex discrimination, sexual harassment and victimisation.
So will the government's next workplace law be the lucrative present Aussies want?
Well, Tony Burke is Workplace Relations Minister and Minister for Employment, and he joins us now. Tony, David Pocock says you didn't guarantee him this bill would increase wages. Can you guarantee us?
It will get wages moving, there's no doubt about that. There's a few different problems that we have with wages at the moment. The key is that enterprise agreements have basically fallen off a cliff. We're now down to only 14% of the workforce covered by them. And they're the way that you basically get better flexibility for business and pay rises every time. This bill, without any doubt, gets those enterprise agreements happening again. Some multi-employer, some single employer, but it gets that moving again. That'll make a huge difference for wages.
Minister, it's a very complicated piece of legislation and quite hard to explain, but from an employer's point of view, you've raised the ceiling of where this captures people in a business. So say I've got 51 employees, bloke down the road's got 151, he negotiates a pay rise for his workers because he's got a bigger budget and more money. How do I avoid getting sucked into that and having to pay myself?
Well, if he's got a single enterprise agreement, which is what you just described, then that's nothing to do with you. So you can't be sucked into that one. It's just impossible. For all employers, we're making it much easier now for them to be able to negotiate directly with their workforce, which is a good thing. It became incredibly legalistic. And while, there's all these arguments, but it's complex, at every level, it's simpler than what we have now. What we have right now is just impregnable. And this legislation, it opens that up. It will get wages moving. It'll make a difference. It'll also close the gender pay gap in different ways. And that's going to be really important.
But you haven't addressed the main issue that I think Steve's gesturing at there, which is the multi-employer bargaining. So, provision...
He asked about a single employer. That's why I answered.
Well, he said they... What was implicit was they're involved in a negotiation. Because of the multi-employer bargaining, you're sucked into it and therefore you have to pay wages that just simply don't work in your business, but they do work in your much bigger competitor's business.
If you're not reasonably comparable to the other business, you can't be joined to it, and the Commission had never let that happen. And that's part of the amendments that have been agreed to with Senator David Pocock.
A criticism that you're facing on this bill is that when you give unions more power in negotiation like this, you inevitably get more industrial action, so that means you get more strikes. Why do you say that doesn't necessarily follow?
Yeah, it's one of the things that we made sure of in amendments that we introduced in the House of Reps, so this is a couple of weeks ago, where originally for industrial action it was going to be averaged across all the businesses. And the view was put really strongly to us, look, it should be the same as what the rules currently are if you were just negotiating with one employer, which is if there's any workforce where at that workplace people vote that they don't want to be involved in industrial action, then that's it, it doesn't happen. And so we've made sure that every test you would have to go through in a single negotiation is the same as what you'd have to do in a multi-employer negotiation. So that leaves arguments about industrial action somehow getting out of hand as nothing but a fear campaign. we've legislatively made sure the test is the same.
Tony, you have to keep Parliament back on a Saturday to pass this. Will you get penalty rates?
I've got to say, all the political arguments, I never knew I was going to be in a fight with the Libs over whether or not we had to turn up on a Saturday. There'll be no penalty rates. I reckon we're already paid well enough and we can front up to work.
Would you be happy if they just didn't show up, Tony?
Oh, no, I like having them there. They make all of us better.
Oh, that's a very diplomatic answer. Well done.
All right, Tony, thanks for your time.
OK, thanks, Heap. See ya.